First, I would like to advertise my second channel. You can have a look on the link in the description. And on this channel, I do mostly electronic stuff and projects. So please have a look and you can subscribe. Today, I would like to have a look inside these walkie-talkie, and I would like to compare these two. These walkie-talkie are CB, so it is for 27 megahertz. These walkie-talkie are from my childhood. I want to make a big, very big project video about walkie-talkie in my second channel, in my project second channel, which is called MDF Rescuer. Please have a look on the channel. Making projects takes some time, and I think into that project is maybe 1 year. So I have this walkie-talkie, and we can have a look on that technology. These walkie-talkie are toys. They are not the high quality, but what is most interesting on these walkie-talkies, that it's easy technology. There are a few transistors, and it's interesting how easily is possible to make a receiver and a transmitter with quite solid parameters. This is the CB1. The nice telescopic antenna is long. For CB, you always need long antennas. And we had a lot of fun with these CB walkie-talkies when I was small, and with my brother and friends on the street. These two walkie-talkies I bought on the internet because I was looking for them for my project, for a video. I paid quite a lot of money for them, but these two walkie-talkies I received today, and this was quite good price for them. I think 5.5 euros, it was quite good price. And I know that it is rubbish, yes, it is. Man who advertised, who was selling these two walkie-talkies, written that they are Morse code walkie-talkie, so I didn't expect it that it could transmit my voice from one room to another room, and it did. So I was quite surprised because I really didn't expect it. So I first would like to show what is inside this walkie-talkie. As you can see, battery department for 9 volt battery. If I have to compare this, it's bad that 9 volt battery doesn't have so much capacity than these three double 8 batteries. Yes, that's bad fact. But these 9 volt battery connectors are very reliable and they last. Oh, not exactly this one, these connectors, what is in this walkie-talkie, but generally that connectors are good. But in this walkie-talkie there are connectors which seems to be not good working. I don't know if it's on this. Do you hear? You move it, you lost your connection. So this is very unreliable connection there. So as you can see, I consider to be this thing, this battery department is better because it can handle large capacities, but problem is that the connectors there aren't so good. All right, so I am going to take the cover from this walkie-talkie. It'd be nice if you see it. I have a lot of light here. So this is all what is inside. You see, that is the fascinating fact about these walkie-talkies, that here are only three, 1, 2, 3 transistors. And when I was small, I was very I was wondering how it can work. Now I know. And I forgot to mention that if you don't want to watch this video, you can skip and watch something else, or skip forward the video as if something is boring to you. Because I am not willing to cut this video. I'm going to make it in one pass. So let's have a look what is actually inside. I have light on my camera. Is this better? Probably yes, because macro can turn on. Now it's on. So here is one. How you can call it? RF, not RF. You call it for sound amplification. Yes, transistor. Here is second. We can call it general purpose transistor. And here is the higher frequency transistor, which is RF. Yes. And what all this does is that this is actually a receiver, it's an Audion. Only one transistor do the receiving, and this is also a transmitter. Only one transistor does transmitting. These two transistors does only sound amplification. When it's receiving, it amplifies the sound from receiver. When it's transmitting, it amplifies the sound from the speaker. What you actually speak inside the loudspeaker. What is good about this walkie-talkie is that the transmitter has a crystal, so it's quite stable transmitter. As you can see, the coil here also has antenna winding here. This coil here is probably for making the antenna larger, or I think not big reason for that coil, because when I disconnected the coil and I put a single wire across, it works the same, so nothing in this is actually nearly for nothing there, the coil. This transformator is for making the sound louder, if I can tell it like this. So this is in this one walkie-talkie, which is NS881. This walkie-talkie at least has some model number, but this one has nothing. What is written here is only walkie-talkie Morse code, and I wasn't able Google something about this, so we can only guess. What is on the back cover is written here UK design registration number 1057719, and here is actually written made in China. I think these two strange places are for adjusting some ferrites there, ferrites. What I would say about this walkie-talkie, that is actually good that it doesn't have a potentiometer, volume potentiometer, because on this walkie-talkie it was the worst thing. It always was broken. You see? This always wanted to broke and not work properly, and this was the reason why you quickly throw this walkie-talkie. I didn't. There is nothing. What would you tell? What is the frequency of this walkie-talkie? But with my SDR, let's call it a receiver, I was able to test this walkie-talkie, and it looks like it is 49.8 megahertz band. So the short antenna is good for this walkie-talkie. So now let's actually take apart the cover and have a look inside. Also would recommend to you to you can speed up the video. I do it when I look some videos of people who I am subscribing or subscribed. There is an option that you can speed the video 2 times. It's very useful. I wish I could have it on my tablet. So let's have a look what is inside this walkie-talkie. It's different. And this walkie-talkie is maybe similar, but as you can see, this walkie-talkie has 2 coils and not 3 transistors, but 1, 2, 3, 4 transistors. So first interesting fact about this walkie-talkie is that it has 2 coils. And it looks like, I don't know, I can only guess, that maybe 1 coil is in tank circuit with in for the transmitter, and 1 is for the receiver. Maybe I can only guess. I am not going to reverse engineer this circuit board today, but it would be nice to have a circuit diagram. This part looks nearly the same like on that second walkie-talkie what I have. It is obviously for sound amplification, and maybe, I don't know now, maybe this is frequency modulation, I don't know, but this walkie-talkie are sure amplitude modulation, AM. But now I think this possibly can be FM modulation, and that fourth transistor can handle the modulation. Also here is interesting to see a small choke. It That's nice. And the antenna here is all length, such a spring here, macro. So that's the antenna. I also want to show you the bottom, that there isn't any integrated circuit. Too much light. Just this. And also these two transistors can be connected in such a configuration that they oscillate. And you can use this button, so it's too much usability from three pieces of transistors. Very good. And it is nearly the same, but with four transistors. Here is something on the case, Brighton. It says Boxer. So it can be, this maybe can be googled, Boxer walkie-talkie, probably. So I think this is nearly end of the video. I would like to again mention my second channel, MDF Rescuer, where I do electronic stuff and projects. So please have a look in the description on the channel. And the last thing what I want to show is the bottom from this circuit board. So it's nice. You can also easily Google the scheme. When you Google this number, NS881, it's on internet. So thank you for watching.